Hello guys, me and my companion in this building, also my boss, we salute you, we say hi. So, as you can see, from company's side, I'm complete. Now, let's move on to what's happening here in Montanes. As you can see, what I haven't filmed because there was no point is these two pieces that I did add at the bow, at the front mast. The construction was exactly the same with this piece. They're identical, so there was no need to film it. Also, I made some, shall we say, minor painting and concealing of the excess paints, as you can see here, also here, also here. I have concealed the black paint. I believe the outcome is pretty good, so I'm not going to mess with it anymore, just going to glue it in position today in this video, and of course sometime I'm going to varnish it with the rest of the deck. Now, in today's video, what we're going to do is to add some rails here that going left and right from the tower bell. The paint here is dry, it's been almost a week. And then I'm going to place the piece that I showed you just moments ago. Then after, this is the part that I'm going to do now. This is what I was talking about. And then I have some more rails to place, as you can see here. And after that, some more rails here. So probably I will do these rails and these rails together, because they're similar. We'll see how it goes, and after that we begin to make some work at the stern. And the moment of painting arrives, because when I reach this point, I'm going to do the painting on the outside of the ship. So I'm pretty close, as you can see, for that. But enough talking. Let me gather my materials and get started. I'm back, guys. I have encountered a small problem. The pieces are made out of metal, not wood that I thought they were. So that means I need to paint them. And the paint will need some time to dry. That's the problem. I'm going to use the same paint that I used for the chimneys, same color. Let me stir up the paint and I'll get back to you. Now, let's start paint. I have to place them all like this, vertically, because this is the surface that is going to be glued on the deck, so I won't apply any paint over there. Okay. Let's see how to do that. Preferably this tool.
here, here. Probably from Wolf. Also the upper part here is going to be covered by a piece of wood, so no need to paint that either. Okay, this is part of the game. Up to the next one. I will try to use just only one coat of paint and do corrections where I need to. That's why I'm applying a lot of paint. So, I need to do that for 20 pieces in total. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. And everything is painted, guys, as you can see. But now, I must leave them to dry. So, let me see what we can do while we wait for these to dry, and I'll get back to you. So, while waiting for the paint to dry, I'll move up to the other rail that I was talking about making on the other video. But as you can see, these two videos are going to be connected, because in this video I started to make the rails for the doorbell, sorry, for the bell tower, and for the first deck, second, somewhere like there, and now I'm going to make the rails for the second deck. Yeah, this is the second deck. So this piece is pre-cut, pre-fixed. I have to clean up all the burn marks. These are also pre-fixed. So let me do that and I'll get back to you. So guys, this was the hard part. This is going to be the top side. This is going to be the lower side. So first of all, let me tell you how I managed to make these marks. Each mark is 1 centimeter away from the other. In total, they are 15. It was a bit difficult, but I found a way. First of all, I measured the length of the straight piece. As you can see, it starts almost here, ends up around here. So after measuring this part, which I know that I have to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pillars, the rest was easy. I divided this length by 9. It was 1 centimeter apart, and then I have to divide this part by 3, starting from the edges. That was easy. The hard part was to figure it out. So, let's begin to assemble. Definitely, I'm going to remind you that these pillars have, you have to sand each side a bit to make it flat. So, let's glue. I'll get that later. Now, I will leave the glue to dry a little and I'll get back to you to do the mounting on the boat. Before doing the mounting, I forgot, guys, we have to place some decorations like cannonballs on the top. So, let's do that. Now, after the glue is dry, we're ready to place the rails on the deck. So, give me a moment and I'll get back to you. So guys, it's not mounted yet. We have to take some measurements. I will remove the camera to take the measurements because I need to be where the camera is. But before, let me show you what are the measurements. The rails... The edges of the rails should begin in the straight line here, where this straight line ends, also on the other side. At the horizontal side, the vertical side, they must begin where this this line ends. So where these two meet lines, this one and this one meet, should be the first edge, and where this line and this line meet should be the second edge, so right about here. So let me do that before, like I said, I have to be where the camera is. I'll glue it and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And glued, and looks perfect. Take a look from the deck. And still we have a lot of pieces to place. So, this is phase one of doing more rails. The paint is not dry yet. So we'll have to wait, probably tomorrow I will film the next one, where I will continue to make the rails that I started to make. The rails beside the bell tower and the rails, where were the other rails? The other rails are over here. So until then, thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon.